So we are going to read Hebrew words. Okay, you can follow me, or you can speak after me, so that you will also have the experience of reading. So before, why I am doing is because in technically, if we are in a classroom setup, I would ask the students to read along with me, or I would assign certain portions to certain students so that they will start reading. But since we don't have that opportunity, what we are going to do, we are going to read together some of the letters. I don't know how long we are going to take, but we will read as much as we can. So only when you start experiencing the reading of Hebrew, then you will get more acquainted with the language, right? So let us begin. The number one. So we all know about the letters and all the symbols that we see here. And yeah, so technically we can read now. So if you are still struggling how to read, I'm going to help you now. So kindly follow with me so that it will help you. So let's start. Number one, Abraham. Okay, Abraham. So we know the name Abraham is Abraham. So you see, Avraham. Here, see, the first syllable is Av. The second syllable is Ra-ham. Okay, Abraham. And then next one is Aaron. Okay, Aaron. So here, this is a compound Shava. That means we have a small symbol here, and this is a Shava. I think it is not a little clear here. So it's a very quick sound. So what we are going to do there is we will just put a small E sound or A sound. So that's why it is Aaron. Okay, Aaron. So here this Nun. Okay, Nun. That is final Nun. I told you that there are certain words that have final forms, right? If you remember, there are few words that have final forms. So Nun is one of that. So this Nun is a final Nun. Okay. And Aaron. Now David. Okay. David. Here is where Vav. Okay. Please take note of that. And here is Dalet. So it may look very similar, but in the printed you can see the difference. But when you are writing, don't make it look alike. You should differentiate Dalet and Vav. David. Okay. And the next is Yosef. Yosef. Okay. Here is Yod, and here is Holam Vav, and here is Samek, and here is Pay. Please note, this is here we can see the Pay, final Pay. Okay. Here we see final Pay. So Yosef. Yosef. And the next is Leah. Leah. You know that, right? All these are biblical names. So now you can visualize how these names are in the Hebrew Bible. We all have in our own translations, but now you can see. Here we have Lamed, that is L sound. Here we have Sere, that is A sound. A means it is actually... in English, it is similar to E, okay, similar to vowel E. So, Le-a, 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 okay, Le-a. And this is little, we should take a little care here. Here, we have name, so here it seems like we have seen, right? We have seen. So now you may be wondering, where is the vowel for name? Okay, here I told you every letter of Hebrew should have a vowel. So here we have name, here we have sin, and then where is the vowel for name? So here we know that this for seeing the dot will be on the right side. Remember, so we have two forms here. If it is seen, that means with the sound of I seen, the dot should be on left side. But here we have dot on the right side, so it is seen. And the for the verb, when some word comes in this way, usually the vowel will be along with this dot. Okay, that means we know that holam, that means O sound. Okay, that there is a vowel with a dot above the letter. So here along with the seen dot, there is a vowel implied, which means how do we read? Moshe. Okay, Moshe. This is how we read Moshe. Okay, and now here Yod, this is Sare, and this is Chait and Kof. How do we read? Yitsa. Okay, Yitsa. Yitsa. So that's how we have to read. Now let's continue. This is very familiar. We know that the God's chosen nation, okay, and also the name of Jacob. This is Israel. Okay, Israel. So all this will become familiar only when you start familiarizing with all the letters and its sound. Okay, so here we have Yod, here we have Sin. So this is not Yish, this is Yis. Okay, the even the short difference should be made correctly, pronounced correctly. So that is Israel. Okay, Israel. And the next is Moab. Okay, Moab. Here, take note of this. This is not B, not Moab. Okay, Moab. This is Moab. Moab. And one other thing that you have to notice, we have to read it aloud. Okay, read it aloud from the maybe from the bottom of your stomach. So when you sing aloud, what you do, we give all the strength. Okay, Hebrew should not be read just like it should not be just coming from your mouth. It should come from your heart. Moa. Okay, and Mitzrayim. Okay, Mitzrayim. Then Paro. Okay, we know Pharaoh, right? Pharaoh. So that's the name of Egyptian rulers, Pharaoh. Okay, so here also take note that if the pay has a dot inside, okay, if the pay has a dot inside, what happens? It is, the sound is like a P. Okay, if there is no dot, it is like a Fa. Okay, this is not Faro, this is Paro. Okay, Paro. Paro. And here root. Okay, it's not root, it's root, it is root. Okay, root. And yeah, here you have to note, here we have a vowel, a comet with Sheva. This vowel comes with Sheva. So how do we read that? How do we read that? So this comes with Sheva, we need to read it as with a vowel O sound. Okay, here we have a comet, that means a T, small T. This has a sound, that means here we have Nun, right? Nun and Here we have T, that means the na, okay, na. And here the T, this is T with a small two dots, that is the seva, which means O. Now if we read it together, na O me, because here we have ayin that doesn't have any sound. So na O me, Naomi. Okay, we read all these in the book of Ruth. Okay, Moab, Ruth, Naomi, and here is another woman's name, Sarah. Sarah, you know that, right? Okay, fine. So I hope you all can follow with me, and as you visualize the Hebrew letters and try to read it along with me, when I try to read, please, you also can read it back. That will help you to get closer with the text, right? Shalom, Shalom, okay. Bayit, Bayit. All these are Hebrew words and it has meaning. But at this point of time, we are not trying to find out the meaning. Shalom means peace, Bayit means house, and you know, Mitzrayim is the name for Egypt. Okay, in the Bible you will not see the name Egypt as Egypt. It is in the Hebrew Bible, it is Mitzrayim. Okay, so in this way, there are a lot of different way of expressing things. So at this point of time, what we are doing is we are just trying to read. We are trying to learn how the each letters pronounce, and how when two or three letters comes together, how it sounds, and how the vowel sounds. So that's what you have to take note. Okay, don't think about meaning, all that. That's not what we are doing now. So Shalom, okay, Shalom. See, Shalom. Ba-it, okay, Ba-it. Now, Bain, okay, Bain, Bain. Is, Is. Here, Aleph doesn't have any sound, so we start with this hirak yod. Here, these two work together as one vowel. I told you, whenever you see a yod near to the hirak, it is possibly a hirak yod, because there is no vowel for yod here. So that means this is a vowel, hirak yod. That means ish. Okay? And davar, davar, davar. And who? Who, who, and Zakar, Zakar, okay. Then Na'ar, Na'ar, right, let us continue. Malak, Malak, and Melek, Bat, okay, Bat. Ahmad, Ahmad, Shama, okay, Shama, Shamar, Shamar, and Bihema, Bihema. Here, if you look at this letter and vowel, I told you that the when the Seva comes at the beginning, okay, here, yeah, you can review your previous classes where we studied about Seva. So when Seva comes at the beginning, there we have a syllable divided. So that is Behema. Okay. Behema. Behema. Okay. And here Na'ara. Okay. Na'ara. So here again, this vowel is very short sound, so you should put a small a sound. So this naara, okay, right. Now, here you see Isa, Isa. So here you need to take note of one thing. So here we have a dagesh inside of seen. So I told you the dagesh can come in two different ways. One is like here. See here the word behema. Here we have bait and there is a dagesh inside. So when the dagesh comes in different letters like beget, kefet, the six letters, so it is actually to change the pronunciation or change the way it is aspired. So that is the function of dagesh when it comes in beget, kefet. So it is also called weak dagesh. But what we are seeing here is a strong dagesh. So what is the purpose of strong dagesh? It actually doubles the letter. So here, how we have to read? Here you should imagine. Okay, sometimes you have to make this imagination. I think I have already explained this in the board, but now it is time that you have to imagine the certain things. So you should imagine there is two sheen here. The sheen is doubled here. So how do we read here? Isha, okay, Isha. Here we have here. Right? Here you should imagine there is another sheen. So the this three makes a syllable. So Isha, Isha, okay, Isha. So this is not Isha. Okay, don't say Isha. It is Isha, Isha. Okay, and the next is here mishpakha. Okay, mishpakha. And so here also you have to notice that here you should think whether this pay has a dot, whether it is a weak dagesh or strong dagesh, because here you see mish itself makes one syllable. Mish itself makes one syllable. So in that case, so here we see another syllable is starting. So if we think this has a strong dagesh, we don't have a vowel for that. So that means it is not a strong dagesh, it should be a weak dagesh. That means it changes the pronunciation of pay. Okay, I told you pay has two ways of pronunciation. If there is a dot inside, it should be P. If there is no dot, it is F sound. So here, mishpakha. Okay, mishpakha. So here we have hate and here we have hey. Okay, so see the difference. So when we see hate, we should pronounce it from the throat. Hey, okay. So mishpakha, mishpakha, right? And the next is derek, derek. Here also we see a dagesh here. So the function is these dageshes are what? Weak dagesh, because it comes in beget kefet letter, right? Eret, okay, eret. And betho, okay, betho. Here see betho, okay, betho. Here this is what? Cough, final cough. So usually you will get a shava at the final cough, but that doesn't have any sound. So betho, okay, betho. Ruah. Okay, I think I remember I told you when the last letter is hey, and when we have a vowel here, usually we should not read the consonant before the vowel. So we should start with the vowel and then we should read consonant. That means ruah. Okay, ruah, ruah. Okay, what do you mean by ruah? It is spirit, the spirit of God. So That's the word. And lifne. Okay? Lifne. Lifne. So here is also another thing you have to notice. This is the final noun. Here is the final noun. And this is the noun comes at the end of a word, but still we have a vowel here. We have a vowel here. Sereyor. That means the A sound. So that means even though the consonant comes at the end of a word, here still we have a consonant yod that comes along with vowel. So that means it is still not the last letter of this word. So that is why we don't see here a final noun. We still see the regular noun. So that means how do we read? Lifne. Okay, lifne. That is the pronunciation. Right. Let us continue. Lechem. Okay, lechem. Lechem. So don't miss out the guttural pronunciation. Lechem. Okay. And son. Okay. Here we have sare. Here we have holam. And here we have new. And all of this doesn't have any sound. So that means son. Okay. Son. And here we have these three dots. So this may not occur very often. So, but the sound you should remember of this vowel, the three dots here, is it's like a oo sound. Okay, and so here we have gimel. So again, we have a dog is here. That is because of beget kefet letter, the weak dog is. So ge. Vu le ka. Okay. Gevu le ka. Gevu le ka. Right. Gevu le ka. So here this it is bait, but still doesn't have any dot here. So it should be vu sound. Vu. Together with the vowel, it is vu. Gevu le ka. Gevu le ka. Here we have kaf and the sound. Right. And amdu. 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 So here this ayin doesn't have any sound. And here comments and the main. So here we end this these three makes a syllable. That means ayin and comments and main. And here we have shava. So that is also the end of the syllable. So that means am du. That means here dalat, and here we have surak. Okay, that is u sound. So don't confuse with vav. Sometimes it has vav, but still you need to think that the dot inside is not about dagish. Okay, it's not about dagish, because here we have dalat, but doesn't have any vowel. So that means it should follow with a vowel. So that is the reason we see amda. Okay, amdu. I mean amdu. Right. Now layila. Okay, layila. Layila. So here this syllable ends lay layila. Okay, and malku, malku, malku. So I hope you are getting along with me in reading the Hebrew words. So I hope this is helping you. So try to follow with me so that we can go quickly. Ba de rek. Okay, ba de rek. Baderik. Baderik. Right? Okay. And let's go to 7. Ha'av. Okay. Ha'av. Ha'av. Habbein. Habbein. Habbait. Habbat. Habbat. Okay. Ha-dava. Now, ham-melek. Okay? Ham-melek. Ha-yish. Ha-yish. Ha-na-ar. Ha-na-ar. Right? And Batim. Batim. And eighth one. It should be noon. I think there is some typing mistake here. Yeah, it should be noon. Banim. Okay, Banim. And Devarim. Devarim. So clue for you that we are going to study. We are going to study these things in the coming classes. But you can just make note of that. The im ending, okay? The im ending. That means the yod and the meim. You can see it together. See it coming in the in these words. Im. Batim. Banim. Devarim, Melakim, Naarim, Arim. So these are plural words, okay? Plural, singular. We all know that in English, plural means denoting multiple things. So, you know, Bath is daughter. Bath is, here we have Habath, right? Habath. Bath is daughter, that means the daughter. So, Bathim, what does it mean? Daughters, okay, and bani. So here, bain means son, okay. Bain means son. So bani means telling son, okay. Bain means son. I mean son, singular. Bani means son. Devar rim. Davar is word, okay. Davar is word. Devarim is words. And Melakim, Malak is king, and Melakim is kings. Okay. Naarim. Naar is young man, and Naarim is young men. Okay, plural. Right. And Avot. Okay. Avot. And Banot. Behemoth. Okay, let me slow it down a little bit. Avot. Vot. Okay, avot. Banot. Banot. Here, see, behemoth. Behemoth. Right? And mis. Mispachot. Mispachot. See, here, pronounce it with the guttural. Mispachot. Na'arot. Okay. Na'arot. At. At. Right? At. Yeah. Maybe we'll be stopped with the number 10. I think at least you might have got some idea about reading words. So I'm not going to push further. So let's finish with this one line. Anashim. Okay. Anashim. And Anashim, okay. Anashim. Aratsot. Aratsot. A-ra-sot. Okay. A-ra-sot. Anashim. A-ra-sot. Okay. And Nashim. Nashim. And the Rakim, the Rakim, and Avadim, Avadim. So you should be, when you are trying to read, you should be able to understand the typed letters, because I think most of the time in the class when we write Hebrew in the board, it will be a little different. But when you see the typed letters, it may be little different. We try to imitate the typed letters, but still it is little different. So you should be able to understand. So Avadim, right? Avadim. And Ammim. Okay, Ammim. So here we have again the doubling dagesh, the strong dagesh. So the dot inside the mim. So it actually doubles the mim. So Ammim, right? Okay, fine. So now I'm going to stop.